Hey guys, this tutorial will show you how to separate Excel data into multiple files using Python and the Pandas library. In my sample workbook, I have sales records for different segments, countries and products. My intention is now to create for each country a separate workbook, which only includes the data for that specific country. If you did it manually, you would need to first filter the column, copy and paste the data to a new workbook and save it. This task can be very tedious, especially when dealing with a large data set. That is why we will do it in Python. But let's be honest, the data we are dealing with is not always so neat and clean like in this example. That is why I have created one more extreme example, where the country names also include different kinds of characters or are sometimes in upper or lower cases. Towards the end of the tutorial, we will see how to deal with that data set. But first, let us start with a simple example. In the workbooks directory, I have created an output folder, which is currently empty. To get started, I have a blank Python file. First things first, I will be importing the required libraries. Go ahead and import pandas spd. If you do not have pandas installed yet, you can install it by typing pip install pandas in your command prompt or terminal. You might also need OpenPyXL, which is an optional dependency of pandas. You can install it by typing pip install openpyxl. Once done, we will also import OS, which is a standard Python module, so no additional installation is required. As a next step, I will create a pandas data frame by typing df is equal to pd.readExcel, followed by the name of the Excel file. As my Python script is in the same directory as the workbook, I only need to type the Excel file name here. If your Excel file is not in the same directory, you would need to specify the exact path to the file. After that, I will create a variable called columnName and set it equal to the column which holds the data we want to split. In my case, I want to separate the Excel data by country. Next, I will create a list with the unique values from that column. We can do this by applying the pandas unique method to our column in the data frame. This line of code will now return a list with all the countries. Having that list allows us to iterate over each country by using a for loop. My approach is to create a separate data frame for each country. Once we have that data frame, we can export it to Excel. To separate our initial data frame by country, we can use the pandas contains method. It will check if our country is contained within the country column. Yet, this line will only return a Boolean series with true and false values. To create an actual data frame, I would need to write it like this. As the next step, I will define an output path. In my example, I would like to save the files in the output folder. The file name should be equal to the country name, which I will then concatenate with the ending xlsx. Finally, to export our data frame back to Excel, I will be using the toExcel method with our output path. Optionally, we could also provide a sheet name. As we do not need an extra column for the index, I will set it to false. And that's all there is to it. To execute the script, I will go back to my command prompt, navigate to the directory of the script, and run the Python file. We should now see the separated Excel files in the output folder. For instance, if I open Canada, we can see that we only have Canada available in the country column. We could try this now also with other columns. Therefore, let me delete the files here. Back in the script, I will change the column to segment. After saving and rerunning the script, we can see that the Excel data has now been separated by the segments. So far so good, but in the real world, the data we are dealing with might be not always so neat and clean as the one from our example. That is why I have prepared another case. As we will tweak our existing code, let me copy our script and paste it into the folder of the second example. If I open up the Excel file, we can see that the countries are sometimes in lower or upper cases. Additionally, sometimes the country names also include empty spaces at the end. So, we might run into issues when running our initial script. Yet, we can easily clean up the data in pandas before exporting the files. Back in our Python file, I will first change the column name back to country. To eliminate the empty spaces in front or after the string, I can apply the pandas strip method to our column in the data frame. Additionally, I will convert the strings in our pandas series to title case. Okay, and that's it. If we run the script, we should see the exact output like in the first example. And also here I will shortly validate one file to check if everything has worked. For the last example, we can go even one step further in regards to the cleanup. As before, I will copy our script to the third example. If we look at the Excel file, we can see that the country names also include various kinds of symbols this time. The issue is that you cannot save file names that contains the following characters. Therefore, we want to remove those characters before separating the data into workbooks. Let us see how we can deal with this in our Python script. First, I will create a list with all the symbols I want to remove. Instead of symbols, you could, of course, also include any other character or string. To escape the backslash in Python, I will type double backslashes here. It looks weird at first glance, but as we will be also using regular expressions later, I will need to wrap it one more time around in double backslashes. Also, I would need to escape the pipe symbol, question mark, and asterisk. Next, I will apply the replace method to our data frame. The first argument will be the characters we want to replace. In my case, I will pass over the list from above. As I want to replace the symbols with nothing, I will type the second argument as follows. As mentioned already, to find the characters in our column, I will use regular expressions. Okay, and that's it. After rerunning the script, we should now see the same output as before, although we had all those characters in our country column. And indeed, just by looking at the file for Germany, we can see the output we have expected. Okay, and that's it for this tutorial. I hope you found this video useful. I will also include a download link to the script and the sample files in the description box. And as always, if you have any questions, please let me know in the comments. Thanks for watching and see you next time.